Hello and welcome back. Today's video is going to be a Project Pan finale. I'm very, very excited. I do love wrapping up some projects. This was finished 5 by Thanksgiving. Pretty short project, only 5 items. I do have some empties though, which is very exciting. If you're interested, I'll link my Project Pan playlist and my Pan That Palette playlist. And yeah, let's just get started. In this project, I had 5 items. One of them I was just counting usage on, and then the other 4 I was trying to finish. I only finished 3 of the 4, but honestly, for such a short project, I actually do think that is very good. I'll start with the item that was usage only, and that was the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. I wanted to use it 15 times, and actually I used it 16 times, and this is the palette that I'm mostly wearing on my eyes today. I really love this palette and I love how this look turned out. So yeah, I pretty much just used, I will say mostly used the matte shades. As I've mentioned in other videos, I have other usage projects. I'm doing the Project 10 uses and I'm doing a Project 100 uses. So even if I just use one eyeshadow on one day, that does count as one use. Whereas today I'm wearing like 5 of these eyeshadows. That is still just one use. So I used this 16 times, which makes me happy because this is one of my favorite palettes. I have pan on it from another project sometime last year, but the mattes in here are so good. I'm wearing a combination of this one, and this one, and then this is the shade all over the lid today. Beautiful formula. There's one dud in here, this shade here, Wild Heart. It's not very pigmented, but the rest is amazing. I really especially love the matte shades, and yeah, I'm pretty happy that I got use out of one of my favorite palettes. As I mentioned, I do have 3 empties, but one of the items I was not able to finish, surprise surprise, it's a lipstick. I tried though, I gotta say, I wore this in quite a few of my videos, and as I mentioned, I'm not really wearing a lipstick at home much, but lip gloss I am reapplying, which you will see later in this project. So this was the Kylie Liquid Lipstick in Bare. This is the second project this year that I had this lipstick in and I didn't finish it. But I did use it quite a bit. Now, I was trying to see if there were some air pockets in there. Maybe, I mean, maybe you can see that. So actually, I mean, I've used this quite a bit. I do think I've made some progress. I had it standing up, but this is not something that settles down very easily, but I'm happy that I used it. So maybe some point I'll finally finish this lipstick, but that day was not today. It is what it is though. I'm actually just really happy that you can even see an air pocket in here. That in and of itself is a win. As I mentioned, there are 3 empties, so let's move on to that. First up, the e.l.f. setting spray. This is the original makeup mist and set, makeup mist and set. They have a matte version and an illuminating. This is the original. This is my holy grail setting spray. I have finished a multitude of these. You can't really see through this packaging, but this is empty. I really do enjoy this. I obviously would repurchase, but right now I have 2 other setting sprays that I think I'm going to use. I have the Mario Badescu lavender spray, and then I have the Pixie one, one of the Pixie ones. I can't remember what it's called, but I have those 2 and they'll work just as well. I use setting spray to prep my face and then also to foil eyeshadows. Sometimes I set my face with it at the end, but usually I end up skipping that step out of pure laziness. But yeah, the most important thing that I really need those for is for foiling eyeshadows. The next product was a deluxe size. I still count deluxe sizes as one item in my empties just because in my makeup inventory, I count deluxe sizes as one item. So I had this little foundation. This is the It Cosmetics CC Plus Full Coverage Cream, whatever it's called, long name. This was a free gift with purchase from Ulta a couple months ago. And I gotta say, I really, really liked this. I had a full size of this several years ago and I really enjoyed it. But at that time, whichever color I had didn't match me all that well. This actually matched me so well. I loved the way this looked. I have combination skin, so this wasn't too dewy. It wasn't too mattifying. It lasts well throughout the day. I was very impressed. The funny thing is though, I can't find the color anywhere on this packaging. So yeah, if I were to buy this, I don't know what color I would get because I know that the color I tried years ago did not match And this, I've searched high and low on this packaging. I cannot find the color. So it's okay. I really don't need any new foundations at this point, but this is on my list of maybe I would purchase it at some point because it was very long lasting on the face and it was medium coverage, which I like, and it wasn't too cakey. So this was great and I'm really, really happy that I even got this sample. Alrighty, and last up, I did finish the lip gloss. As I mentioned, I'm not really reapplying lipstick, but sitting around at home, I have been reapplying lip gloss. I mean, it's kind of like using lip balm, so it has worked out very well for me. I have finished a lot of lip gloss this year. This is the ColourPop Ultra Glossy Lip in Aquarius. I did scrape this all out. I've mentioned before, I don't usually take the stoppers out of lip gloss because it is quite messy, but I do that with concealers. This is a nice mauve-y color. I like it, but this used to be my favorite formula, but it's just not anymore. It's a little bit sticky, and I like the ColourPop Luxe glosses better, and I like a whole bunch of other lip glosses better, so this was my last one in this style of packaging from ColourPop, which makes me very happy because, yeah, these are just not my favorite anymore. And also they had switched to the brush tip, which I must say that the brush tip, it makes it like a little splotchy as you put it on your lips. I feel like I have to then blend it out with my finger, whereas with a doe foot, I just think it gives a smoother application. So yeah, I felt like I would put this on, but then I had to use my finger to kind of rub it in to make it more even looking. I mean, it's fine, but doe foots are better. So I'm so happy that I finished another lip gloss, and I'm really happy I don't have any more of these ColourPop ones because yeah, they're just not my favorite anymore. Alrighty, that is it for this Project Pan finale. I'm pretty happy that I have 3 empties and I got great use out of that palette. And I actually use that lipstick a lot. I just was not able to finish it. So I do think that that is pretty good. I'm happy with the results of this short project and I'm happy to be done with another project. So if you want to catch up on all my other Project Pan videos, I will link those playlists. That is it. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.